this episode brought to you by Noble Gold. Now, it's not often you get a gift for yourself in the holidays, is it? So, how does a free 22-karat American Gold Eagle coin sound? Not bad, huh? A free 22-karat American Gold Eagle coin in a special presentation box. But it's not that simple. To qualify, you have to take out a precious metals IRA or 401k rollover with Noble Gold. So call 877-646-5347 and get this special coin offer, but don't hang around. That's 877-646-5347.
This was started when the mainstream media stopped, dropped any pretense of being unbiased and actually chose sides during this election. This fire was started when you completely ignored, for example, our investigation of Hunter Biden. You know, no evidence of wrongdoing there, and now we find out after the election, no, there is a fair amount of evidence to the point that we have a real FBI investigation.
Senator, so all right, it's I've had enough of hearing
it's
this.
Listen, I've had enough of this too. It's
no,
the
Senator,
bias of the media.
It has created a situation where
Republicans and conservatives do not trust the mainstream media, and that is what's destroyed the credibility of the media and our institutions, and
really shaking confidence in the election result.
Sitting here watching Chuck Todd get all bent out of shape and triggered over these extremely valid criticisms is seriously raising my blood pressure. I mean, this guy is a prime example of why people distrust the media. And I've been talking about Chuck Todd for years now, so most of you have probably heard a lot of this by now. But for some good examples here, his wife gets paid millions by the Democrat Party. The Democrat Party is her client, and he never discloses this. And you know what? Anytime he gets called out for this, he reacts very similarly to the way he's reacting right now to Senator Ron Johnson. Todd himself has been busted multiple times hosting parties for Democrats and even renting his homes out to Democrats. In fact, he rented his home out to the presidential candidate, Amy Klobuchar.
You have spent... much of your time in the last 2 years carrying a lot of this crazy conspiratorial water for President Trump.
So again, I didn't criticize Democrats when they were talking about potential hacking of voting machines, but now it's quackery, now it's conspiracy theory.
Yeah, exactly. Like, where is the self-awareness? Chuck Todd and NBC, MSNBC, all these networks for the last 4 years have been trotting out insane conspiracy theories to explain their election loss. That Trump is a Russian agent. They literally have seriously been trotting that out for the last 4 years. And just this look on Chuck Todd right now, just this dumbfounded, retarded look. Like, oh, are you saying that when we said that Vladimir Putin hacked election machines and stole the vote for Donald Trump, that was a conspiracy theory? And just one more thing about a previous part that I forgot to mention is that Todd mentions that he's had enough of hearing this. This unelected propagandist clearly sees himself as above an elected official, which I guess surprises nobody. Have you ever once heard Chuck Todd talk to a Democrat this way? Of course not. They pay his bills. And just like Ron Johnson said about the media covering up the Hunter Biden story, he's absolutely right. The media and the social media platforms literally use CCP-style censorship to bury what was an inconvenient story to the Democrat Party in order to protect Joe Biden ahead of the election. And as it turns out, Hunter Biden is under active investigation from the FBI.
That's the problem, Chuck. There's a double standard here, and we are not being transparent, and we are dismissing the concerns of tens of millions of Americans. Again, I didn't light this fire. This fire was lit over 4 years ago, and we have destroyed the credibility of the, you have destroyed the credibility of the news media by your bias, and of course people like James Comey, Andrew McCabe, John Brennan destroyed the credibility of the FBI and our justice system as well. We have an enormous problem in this country. It's unsustainable, and the only way you solve it is with information and transparency and hearings and investigations.
So
it's not quackery. It's not conspiracy theory. It's what's going to be required.
Let me ask you this. Then why didn't you hold hearings about the 9/11 truthers? There's plenty of people who thought 9/11 was an inside job. So you're basically saying there's enough people who believe that conspiracy theory, I held hearings on what I figured was the most relevant issue. Are you going to do it? How about the moon landing?
Obviously, this election, when you...
Did he just compare investigating widespread election fraud and possible hacking of Dominion voting systems to moon landing conspiracy theories and 9/11 conspiracy theories? Really? Does he really want to make that comparison? Because if you actually go back and look at the 9/11 conspiracy theories, you're going to find that it was around 60% of Democrats that believed that Bush either knew about 9/11 and let it happen or was actually behind it himself. 60% of Democrats. And let's not forget that for 8 years under George Bush, many in the media and many Democrats referred to it as the Bush regime because they believed that Bush had stole the election twice. Now, the media is never going to remind you of this, but in 2005, Democrats tried to stop the election of George W. Bush in much the same way that Republicans are doing right now with Joe Biden, claiming, quote, widespread voting irregularities. Sound familiar? But as you can guess, the media reaction was much different. I mean, just look at this CNN article from 2005. Alleging widespread voting irregularities on Election Day, a group of Democrats in Congress objected Thursday to the counting of Ohio's 20 electoral votes, delaying the official certification of the 2004 presidential election results. And then it says the objecting Democrats, most of whom are House members, said that they wanted to draw attention to the need for aggressive election reform in the wake of what they said were widespread voter problems. So isn't that exactly what Ron Johnson is advocating for here? And yet he's being attacked as some sort of right-wing conspiracy kook that's undermining the Americans' institutions at the behest of Vladimir Putin. I just find it funny that back then in 2005, that the media was not accusing Democrats of attacking or undermining democracy. Weird. That's all for this one. Please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. If you want to support this channel, you can find all those links in the description or pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.